A word about diet. PD does a wonderful job in removing waste products and excess fluids from your blood. But it can't completely take over the work healthy kidneys do in balancing the important substances in the blood. That's done through the medicines you'll need to take, but mostly through your controlling the type of food you eat and the amount of fluid you drink. PD allows a lot of variety and flexibility in what you can eat and drink. If you choose CAPD or CCPD, we'll work with you to develop a diet plan that's right for you, that takes into account your overall health, any medicines you'll need to take, and what you and your family like to eat. To learn more about nutrition, see the video on that subject in this series.
Taking all the medicines prescribed for you is also very important. You may need to take high blood pressure pills, some multiple vitamins, and a special medicine to keep your bones healthy, as well as the medicines you may be taking for other problems you may have. You may also get EPO, a special medicine that prevents anemia. Well, that's when your body is not making enough red blood cells, causing you to feel very tired. To learn more about EPO, look at that tape in this video series.
One thing we're especially careful about in PD is the risk of peritonitis, an infection of the peritoneum. Peritonitis often happens when germs get into the peritoneal cavity through the catheter. Peritonitis is treatable with antibiotics when recognized early enough. That's why an important part of your training will be learning how to keep a germ-free environment while you do the procedure. No matter which form of PD you choose, you'll continue to meet with your doctor and healthcare team on a regular basis to discuss your overall health, diet, and review your checkups and medicines.
The team will always be available to you when you come into the center for tests and checkups, and will also be available to you by telephone on a 24-hour basis for as long as you're on treatment. As you've seen, peritoneal dialysis can give you a lot of freedom.
There was a fellow in here yesterday who travels in a regular van, not a motor home, he and his wife. And he's set up to hangs his bag from a hook on the top of the van, does his exchanges in the van, uses the spray type soap to keep his hands disinfected, dumps the stuff in service station restrooms, you know, and goes on about his business. I mean, it is very, very flexible for him.
And I went on vacation last summer, and I have a relative, and you call ahead, and they ship the supplies there. And when I get there, they're there. And I flew, and we rented a car there, and it was no trouble.
I'd say the basic attitude that is helped me the most would be just take it in stride and just think of it as brushing your teeth in the morning. Instead of kidney dialysis, just think of it as a common everyday thing that you have to do. Just pretend that everybody else in the world has to do it. You know? It's just like an everyday thing. But yet talk it out, you know. If you do have feelings, just talk it out.
Your social worker is trained to help you with non-medical concerns and more. You can learn more about coping by looking at that video in this series.
Is there anything else?
Cost for treatment.
Right.
You'll be relieved to know that most, if not all, expenses are covered by Medicare, as well as many private insurers and state programs. Your social worker can answer many questions about coverage or direct you to others who can help.
Let's review some of what we've learned today. To begin with, peritoneal dialysis should be thought of in two ways. CAPD is a dialysis process that goes on continuously throughout the day. You do the exchanges yourself at times and places of your own choosing. No machines are used. CCPD is also a continuous dialysis process, with the exchanges done at night while you sleep, with the help of a machine called the cycler. Both must be done every day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. In both, your blood never leaves your body, since the dialysis process is done entirely inside your abdominal cavity. Both require that a catheter be placed into your abdominal cavity. While you still need to take some medicines, a PD diet gives you variety and flexibility. We talked about EPO, a special medicine for treating anemia. Through the special training you'll receive, you'll play a greater role in your own care. Most expenses for CAPD and CCPD are covered by federal, private, and state insurance programs. With CAPD and CCPD, you're more in control of your life. You can schedule your treatment around work, school, travel, your family, things you like to do. And we've said that if you choose peritoneal dialysis, you'll have a dedicated and concerned healthcare team working with you and your family to give you the best care possible. All of us here hope you've learned something about peritoneal dialysis from this video and suggest you take the time to watch the other videos in this series. Even if you're not considering other treatment choices now, as your condition changes, you may want to look into the other choices discussed in this series.